Hey, welcome back to Wonder Wednesday. I'm John.
And I'm Amanda.
And we're both part of the team here at Wonderopolis. And in this video series, we're looking at some great ways that you can use Wonderopolis to engage kids in remote learning. Teachers and caregivers everywhere are working really hard to help kids learn at home right now. And so we hope this helps you use the features of Wonderopolis in the best way possible.
So at wonderopolis.org, we answer questions from curious kids every single day. And every Wonder Wednesday, we plan to take a closer look at some of our most popular wonders. This week, we're working with one of our top 10 wonders, which is, what is a Rube Goldberg machine? And the Wonderopolis feature that we'll be demonstrating this week is vocabulary. So you'll notice as you're reading that some of the words in each wonder are highlighted. These are the wonder words, which you'll also notice are listed in a box off to the right of the main text. Now, when you hover over a wonder word, you'll actually be able to read the definition, which is a great support as you're reading through the wonder. And you can also practice after reading with the Wonder Word Challenge, which is a matching game that actually lets you see how well you remember the definition of each word. So the way you play this game is you can just drag and drop the wonder word over to its definition to see if you got it, which is pretty great. Now, as a former teacher, there are a few ways that I probably would have used the wonder words for vocabulary practice. I always found it useful to give students authentic ways to practice with new words. And in today's remote learning environment, I might challenge them to include a wonder word in a tweet and tag our class Twitter account. I might also ask them to use wonder words in conversation during a class video chat. And there are plenty of ways to practice new vocabulary remotely. John, as a parent, how would you use vocabulary with your kids at home?
Yeah, so years ago, I heard a quote that's always stuck with me, and that's you should never make fun of someone who mispronounces a word because that means they've been reading. So I often hear my kids mispronounce new words. I have a third grader and a kindergartner. And so thinking about it from a parent's perspective, parents are probably not gonna use it as rigorously as educators might, but some simple ways that you could help kind of reinforce these vocabulary words is asking your child later in the day, hey, remember that word complex? What did that word mean again? Or maybe asking for an example. But just finding a way a couple times later in the day to kind of bring those words up again, to reinforce them, to use them in other contexts correctly, that can really help strengthen and build vocabulary. And then just this wonder in general is a really great opportunity to do some deeper learning about the six or seven different kinds of simple machines and how simple machines are different from complex machines. There's really a lot even beyond vocabulary that you could do with this top 10 wonder in particular.
Well, we hope that you join us again next week for Wonder Wednesday. But until then, if you have any questions or need anything, please reach out to us via social media. We're here to help. So keep wondering, everybody.